Do subscribe to Ekeeda channel and press bell icon to get updates about latest engineering, HSE and IIT JEE main and advanced videos.
Hello friends, in the last lecture we have studied about spontaneous process or spontaneous reaction. In that, what we have got to know that a reaction is spontaneous as well as unidirectional as well as irreversible if it takes place by its own. So now we are going to discuss about what is the role of energy that will decide whether the reaction or whether the process is been spontaneous or not. So let us talk about that. So now we are going to talk about that is what is the relation between the energy and spontaneity. So first of all, let us do some few criteria. Let us understand the few criteria that will make us to know that which process or which kind of reaction will be said to be a spontaneous reaction or spontaneous process. So starting with it, the first one is the criterion of a chemical reaction to take place simultaneously is that the product of the reaction must be more stable than that of the reactant. So it says about stability of product as well as the stability of reactant. Suppose while conversion of a reactant into product, if the product is not stable, then what happens? Then that product will not be formed, because the main criteria to form a product is the product should be more stable than that of the reactant. And in this case, suppose if the reactant is being more stable than that of the product, then the reaction won't proceed further, means it won't have a forward reaction. And most probably we will have no product, no amount of product formed or in a huge quantity or more quantity. So that plays a very important role that when it comes to stability. So the stability of the product should be more than that of the stability of the reactant. Then only the formation of the product, or then only the process that we know as chemical reaction will occur in a forward direction. And that is nothing but the unidirectional, and when it comes to spontaneous process. So learning about the second one, that is the substance having more energy are less stable, where those that have less energy are more stable. Yes, it is also true to understand that is if a substance or any kind of state, it has suppose more energy. So if, because it has more energy, that it means it is very less stable. And a process or a system when we are talking about, and if it has less energy, then it means it is more stable. This is very similar to that what we have discussed in our earlier point, in which what we have discussed is that if the stability of the product is more than that of the stability of the reactant, then only the reaction will proceed, or then only the reaction will will behave like a spontaneous process. So in this case, the thing that I'm going to talk about is that is when it comes to energy, then the energy of the product is comparatively less than that of the energy of the reactant. Then only, because it will decide, because the energy of the products are less, that means the products are more stable. And if the energy of the reactants are more, that means they are less stable. So eventually the reaction will move forward from lower stability to higher stability, or we could say that the reaction will move forward, or the process will move forward from higher energy to lower energy. So this is nothing but a spontaneous process that takes place, and these are the few criteria which depends on the energy as well as the stability so as to make a spontaneous process. So these were the two points. So let us check what is the third point. The spontaneous chemical change must accompanied with the release of energy as heat. If the energy is being released, so this means what? This means that the products are being more stable because the energy has been released. This can be, we could discuss this thing by the graph also. Suppose if we have a graph where this is the reaction coordinates, as you could see, and this is something which is related to potential energy, or we could say as energy itself. Suppose what happens if this A stands for the energy of the reactants, and when it will it is a state where energy of a reactant has been present, and suppose if the reactants are suppose small a plus b, suppose if the reactants are small A plus B. So whenever they will react with each other, the first thing that when we are talking about thermochemistry, then an intermediate state will be formed, that is basically known as a complex or transition state, where the two reactant molecules will collide with each other or will form a very intermediate, very excited state, which has more energy than that of the reactant. But after this, what happens is, if the energy get lost, or if the energy of the product that has been formed, suppose the product energy is small c plus t. So it has been observed that this product has been very much having low energy than that of the original reactant that we had. So I will name this as state B. So in this case, what I could see as the product has less energy than that of the reactant. So the difference between this energy, that is the gap between this energy of the reactant and the product, is basically known as enthalpy of the reaction. And in this process, suppose if this is the difference that you could see, that means the energy has been evolved from the reaction. And since energy has been evolved from the reaction, it will be said to be an exothermic process. So because of this reaction is an exothermic process, means the energy has been released from the system, that energy that has been released from the system, that will make the product to be more stable, because now product don't have that much amount of energy than that of the reactant. In fact, it has less energy than that of the reactant. So therefore, product is having less energy and hence it is more stable. But the delta H that we have, or the heat of reaction, or the enthalpy of the reaction that we have, it would be negative. So this negative clearly indicates that the energy has been lost from the system. So usually what it happens is, most of the exothermic reactions are said to be spontaneous process. So this is what this point is talking, we are now discussing about this thing, that is the spontaneous chemical reaction must be accompanied with release of energy as heat, or basically we could see it as exothermic reaction. So most of the exothermic reactions are basically spontaneous reaction. So for example, we have, as you could see, that is when KOH, that is a base, when it is reacted with nitric acid like HNO3, and when basically this is an acid base neutralization process, so it will form a salt of KNO3, that is potassium nitrate plus water. So in this process, what happens is the enthalpy of the reaction, or the change in enthalpy that we observe, or the heat of reaction that we could say, it is found to be minus 57 kilojoule. So this minus 57 kilojoule means this much amount of energy has been released from the system, and that makes this reaction to be an exothermic reaction. So therefore, this is an exothermic reaction where the stability of the KNO3 plus H2 is more than that of the KOH and HNO3, which could also be said as the energy of the KNO3 and H2 is less than that of the energy that have of KOH and HNO3. So this reaction, because since it is an exothermic reaction, this could be said to be an spontaneous process. So now let's move on to the further thing, that is, although spontaneous changes are exothermic that we have discussed right now, but the exothermicity is not sufficient criterion for spontaneity of a process. Because recently we have studied that all the exothermics, or most of the exothermic reactions, are basically spontaneous process and they take place by its own. But it is not necessary that every kind of exothermic process would be spontaneous. In fact, there are also some kind of endothermic process that are showing spontaneous process. Let us talk about that also. For that, we have an example here. If ice melts spontaneously above 0 degree Celsius, and we know that ice melts spontaneously above 0 degree Celsius, but in this process, what happens? This ice, which is present in solid state, will now have something which will have more, if we increase the temperature of this, then in this thing, since we are increasing the temperature, since we are providing heat to the system, so the heat is being intaken towards the system, and in this case the delta H will be positive. and then only this ice will be converted into H2O, which is in liquid state if the temperature is in increase more than 0 degrees Celsius. So since the conversion of ice to liquid, the energy is being evolved or the energy is being needed to the system so as to convert the solid ice to the liquid water. So since this is an endothermic process, so being an endothermic process also, this will be said to be a spontaneous process. Earlier what we have got to know that exothermic processes are said to be a spontaneous process. So it is not necessary that that every exothermic reaction should be an spontaneous process. So there are also endothermic processes that are basically spontaneous process. So this is was the relation between what is the relation between the energy as well as spontaneity of a particular reaction or for a particular process. So thank you friends for watching this video. I hope you have liked this video and you have understood this concept very clearly, and you share this video with your friends, and just don't forget to subscribe to Ekeeda channel. Thank you so much.